Hi everyone, this is Lisa from Canine Clips, and this is Bear. And Bear is a Shih-Tzu Terrier cross dog breed, and I'm going to be giving him a full groom today. And we're going to be doing a three-quarter inch blade on the body, and just of course scissor trimming the rest. So I just wanted to give you a quick little video of that. So he is a good boy. He's been coming to me already for 7 years, since he was a little puppy. Since he was 9 months old. So I guess that makes him about 8 years old. But that's all approximate. So he's used to what I'm doing here. He's still a little nervous, as you can tell. He's still a little shaky. So I'm still not his favorite person to see. But of course he tolerates me. If you do like this video, I'd really appreciate it if you could please subscribe to my channel. And you can check out my other videos that I have posted as well about dog grooming. I groom lots of a variety of dogs. And a different haircut on each one, all depending on what the owner prefers. And this way my owners get to see how good their dogs are. And how they behave for me when they're being groomed. I'm just going to layer down the face kind of, but kind of leave it a little bit longer because of course we are leaving the body longer. So you don't want a really short face. And you can see he has lots of hair in his ears there. We will pluck that out. You can see he's been scratching, a little bit of redness. It gets kind of itchy when there's lots of hair in there, because that's where the wax sticks to. And it makes the hair a little heavier, and then the wax actually, or the hair actually grows down into the ear. I'm just trimming the hair outside of the ear canal. And since I'm here, and he's staying so nice, I am going to pluck that out. Get that out for him because it does grow quite fast in there, obviously, just like the body. Except when the wax gets on there, it makes it heavy, and then it grows back into the ear canal. And of course, it's itchy for the dog and annoying because they can't get to it. And then the wax doesn't dislodge, it stays stuck on the hair. Once you take all that hair out, once the wax has nothing to stick to, so that when the dog shakes his head or scratches, the wax actually comes loose. And then you'll notice they won't be as frustrated with their ears. Just about, buddy. There we go, got it all out. So there's quite a bit in this here, as you can see. I'll just continue on. Just gonna round out the face a little bit. Side. The other side's got pretty much the same amount of hair in it. And he's still got a little bit of redness where he was scratching there. He's right at the top there. So once I get all this hair out, hopefully he won't be as bothered by his ears. The owner should notice a decrease in him scratching that a little bit. And I will put a solution in when I'm done as well, the bath. Basically, when I'm done the full groom, I put a solution in before they go home, and then that dries out any wax that may be in there. And then when the dog shakes his head, it'll come dislodged. Talking, buddy. Not your fun place to be. It's okay. There you go, buddy. And there's that one. So same kind of hair in there. Just inside the ear. It's hard to believe that that much hair is in there. All right, good boy. Okay, so we got the face and the ears done. Well, and we're going to start on the feet now. And nails. I'm going to get all that hair out between the pads. I know that. His quiet protest. Tell by his nails, he likes to go for walks. They're a little bit worn down. And then again, I'm keeping the body a little longer, so I don't want to go too far up there, so I just kind of want to round them so that they kind of blend, but of course still a little bit shorter so they're not picking up too much stuff. As the weather is going to get a little colder and damper for us. Good boy. Yeah, it's a good boy. Okay, on to the front foot. Get a close up here. He's so cute. It's okay. We got one bleeder there. That can happen. That's quite normal for the nails to bleed. It's okay. Just put on some styptic powder. Where are you? There you go. Just damp the... Oh, there's two there. Damp the nail into the styptic powder and make sure there's good contact. And then the nail should stop bleeding. Okay, and that's what I use right there. Okay, other side, Brad. Okay, so I'm gonna do the other feet. Okay. Nice. So I get the dew claw there. Okay, last foot on the back there. He's gonna lay down for us. Okay, don't bad cut the nails. These ones are, like I said, already kind of worn down, so I don't need to take much off of them. But as winter comes and there's snow on the sidewalks, those nails won't get worn down as quickly. Okay, and I'm just going to comb out the ears and give them a little trim, same with the tail, and then trim up the bum area and the undercarriage before I give the bath there. And because I am doing a longer cut, I'm going to scissor cut the bum area. Okay, and then just so it blends a little bit nicer. Okay. ears done. Now we're gonna do the bum area. Okay. And then we'll use the clippers. I'm going to use a number 5 underneath and I'll see how that works. Because it is a little thicker, so I want to make sure I get real close in there. Little mats, so I'm going to use a number 10 for those areas. And then we'll be ready for the bath. So we're just gonna get him into the tub. Come on, bud. Come on. Come on. Oh, baby. There we go. Okay, there we go. Shower there. Thank you. cleaned up here. We'll give them a good rinse. And you want to make sure you'll get all that soap out. Or it might be the dog can get itchy if there's any soap residue left. Okay, and there we go, and we're ready for the blow dryer now. So back to the table we go. All right, and now we are ready for our blow dry. Smaller one that fits a little bit better. Now I'm going to get the 3/4 inch blade. Get them all finished up. And the 3/4 inch blade isn't taking off very much, so I'm gonna actually switch to the 3 3/4 blade, because I'm pretty sure when you come for a grooming, you want some hair cut off. I'm just gonna do a little bit shorter, just so we get a nice cut and it can grow. There we go. And so we'll still leave lots of length, but I don't want someone to come in for a grooming and it not take off any hair, because then what's not very fair to pay for a little trim here or there. And this still is not taking off a lot, but it's still trimming everywhere nice and even. So. Once I give him his second blow dry, I'll be able to use the scissors to kind of blend. Because sometimes in these crevices or tight corners of the body, they don't, the clippers don't get in there with the longer blades. So it's nice to just kind of see how the blow dry lifts up the fur, and then you can go back with the scissors and kind of clean that up. Switch spots with you. Okay, so I'm just gonna take them off the table for a second. No, that's okay. Just so I can use the clean it off before I blow dry. It's okay. Okay, there you go. There you go. Okay. Okay, so now we're going to give another blow dry. And then we'll get all finished up here. I'm going to get this one. Come here. Okay. Big fan of the blow dryer, as you can see. Now I'm going to just do the final trim. And sometimes I'll blow dry the head without the ear protection on, but since he already didn't like it with it on, I'm not gonna cause that extra stress on him. And he is getting a little older. Well, he's still quite young yet, but once they reach 8 or 9, sometimes they really don't like that blow dryer noise. Not sure if when the dog gets older, their hearing obviously changes, but different frequencies can sometimes bother them. So I'm just going to err on the side of caution since he's not a big fan of the blow dryer. So I'm just going to go around and kind of trim up anything I see. And he does have a lot of curl in his hair. So of course I'm never going to get anything perfect. But just kind of get everything looking even. Okay, and I'm just going to check the bum area to make sure it blended nice, because sometimes after the blow dry, yeah, you can get some that stick out a little bit. It's hard to see on the camera, but this kind of was bowed out a little bit more, so I kind of want to blend that in. going to comb out the tail once again. And after the blow dry, it can get a little tangled. It's okay. Go. Okay, and then I'm going to finish with some ear solution and brush his teeth as well. And then we'll be all done. So I hope you enjoyed the video. And I hope you subscribe to my channel and let me know what you think. And please keep watching. And I hope you have a great day. So thanks again. And we'll see you again. Bye-bye.